So there are five basic magnetic quantities. And then the first is magnetic flux density, which has a symbol of letter B. So yung magnetic flux density is the measure of how strong a magnetic field will be formed. So the formula is magnetic flux density is equal sa flux per unit area. So ang flux is in Webers, and then ang area is in square meters. And then ang SI unit ng magnetic flux is in Tesla. So actually may equivalent yung Tesla pa, which is will be encountered later. And then second is the reluctance. So reluctance, so yun yung symbol niya, letter R. It is opposition to the creation of magnetic field when magnetic force is applied. So ito yung medyo synonymous term for resistance in terms of electricity. Kasi ito is the opposition of the creation of magnetic field. And then the formula for reluctance is magnetic force divided by the flux, where magnetic force is in ampere turn and then flux is in Weber. So ang formula, ang SI unit ng reluctance is ampere turn per Weber. So next is magnetizing force, or H. H has a formula of MMF over L. So ang MMF mo is in ampere turn, and then L is length, which is in meter. So ang formula for magnetizing force, or the SI unit for magnetizing force, is ampere turn per meter. So synonymous to with a magnetic flux. Pero dito ang tinitignan is the force creating the magnetic field. Next is permeability. It is the measure of how easily a magnetic flux is created in a material when the MMF is applied. So yan yung definition ng permeability. And then meron tayong permeability constant, which is nasa mga calculators yon, and then may encounter din natin later, lalo na in Faraday's and Lenz law. So ang formula for permeability is magnetic flux divided by the magnetizing force. So ang flux is in Tesla divided by ampere turn per meter. And then it can be summarized as Henry per meter, wherein ang equivalent ng unit na Henry is Tesla divided by ampere turn. Kaya naging siyang Henry per meters. Last fundamental magnetic quantity is the permeance. It is the reciprocal of reluctance. So, baliktarin nyo lang yung reluctance, that is the permeance. Ang unit ng permeance is Weber per ampere turn. So, example number one for basic or fundamental magnetic properties, quantities. So, sabi dyan, a wire used as a magnet was applied with a flux of 3 Weber, has a 5 by 2 meter dimension with MMF of 10 ampere turns. Determine letter A, magnetic flux density, letter B, reluctance, letter C, magnetizing force, letter D, permeability, and last for letter E is permeance. So, ang mahalaga rito is identify the given doon sa problem. And then be sure to it, gaya ng mga previous physics problems natin, is that the value you are substituting has an SI unit. So kung hindi siya naka-SI unit, convert it. For example, for the length, ang given is in centimeter, convert it to meter. So again, be cautious doon sa paggamit ng mga units. As much as possible, use units in SI. Or standard units. Kasi yun yung mga may direct equivalent with other units. So for the flux, magnetic flux density, it is solvable using the formula flux divided by unit area. So may given ka na dimension. So sabi dyan, 5 by 2. So pag ang given is 5 by 2, so malamang yung object is rectangular in form kasi yun na yung dimension. So, if 5 by 2, so length times width, so assume mo na rectangle na yun. So, masosolve mo na yung area, which is simply 5 times 2. So, flux is 3 Webers divided by the area, which is 5 times 2 meters, making it 3 Webers divided by 10 meter per second. 10 square meters, rather. So, flux or magnetic flux density is equal to 0.3 Weber per square meter. Next is the reluctance, which is can be solved by the formula MMF divided by the flux, where MMF is already given sa problem. Diba? So that is 10 ampere turns divided by 3 Webers. So ang sagot is 3.33 ampere turn per Weber. So direct substitution lang. Ang magiging mahirap lang dito is if hindi mo alam yung mga relationship ng bawat units. So mahalaga to identify yung fundamental magnetic quantities, identify mo yung formula niyan. Kasi may cases na ito yung given, nahanapin mo yung isa, vice versa. Sa limang fundamental magnetic quantities, there are interrelated with each other. So, letter C, magnetizing force. So, ang formula is MMF divided by the length. So, usually, di ba, 5 by 2, di ba, length times width. Wala ka naman narinig na width. Width times length. So, that is length times width. So, ang length mo would be automatically be 5 meters. And then, ang MMF is 10 ampere turn. So, 10 divided by 5. Ang sagot is 2 ampere turn per meter. So, for the permeability, it is solvable by the formula flux divided by magnetizing force. So, nasolve mo yung magnetizing force. So, divide mo lang siya sa flux, which is 0.3 Tesla divided by 2 ampere turn meter. So, ang sagot is, di ba, ang Henry is in Tesla divided by, or Tesla over ampere turn meter. Or, Tesla over ampere turn, yun yung Henry. So, may iwan yung meter dito, kaya ang sagot is 0.15 Henry per meter. Last is permeance. So, that is the reciprocal of reluctance. So, na-solve mo yung reluctance na 3.33 ampere turn. So, for the permeance, that is simply 1 divided by 3.33 ampere turn per Weber. So, reciprocal nun, itong unit sa denominator mo, is 0.3003 Weber per ampere turn. So, after discussing the nature of problems regarding the fundamental magnetic quantities, so, i-discuss naman natin next are the magnetic problems that is related with the current producing a magnetic field, which is discussed by the Faraday and Lenz law. And then, the basic formula in solving force or magnetizing force na ang mga given are current, yung length, yung flux, pwede rin given is the charge, velocity, and then yung angle. So, magbigay tayo sa example number 1 sa mga application naman. So, sabi sa problem, a particle with a charge of negative 1.6 times 10 raised to negative 19 coulombs and mass of 9.11 times 10 raised to negative 31 kilogram moves along the positive axis from left to right. If it enters a 3 Tesla magnetic field, which is in the XY plane and points at 45 degrees above the positive axis. So after it has been in the magnetic field, the particle moves in a circle, and then if the radius of its path is 2 times 10 raised to negative 10 meters, what is the speed of the particle? So, yun ang unang hinahanap, the speed of the particle. Next is, what is the magnitude of the force of the particle? So, ang hinahanap is the speed and the force. Eh, di ba may alam tayong formula for the force, which is yung force is equal sa I or current times length times the magnetic field, sine theta. Tapos, meron pa tayong isa, which is derived from that. Yung force is equal sa charge times the velocity times the magnetic field and then the sine theta. So, yung yung charge and the velocity was derived from the length tsaka yung current. Diba? As discussed previously. So, ito yung mga given. So, ang charge is 1.6 times 10 negative 19 coulombs. Ang mass is 9.11 times 10 raised to negative 31 kilograms. So, naka-SI unit yung charge tsaka mass. And then, ang tawag doon, equivalent ng coulomb is ampere second. Diba? Then, theta is 45 degrees. Take note, degrees, ha, hindi radian. Then, the magnetic field is 3 Tesla, which is equivalent sa 3 Newton per ampere meter. At ang Newton is equivalent sa kilogram meter per second square. So, doon yung makikita yung importance ng relationship ng mga SI unit. Diba? Kung di mo alam equivalent ng Newton, mahirap ka mag-cancel ng units. Again, ang Tesla is equal sa Newton per ampere meter. So, ang given na radius is 2 times 10 raised to negative 10 meters. So, pag may radius, ibig sabihin yan, there is a circular path. Diba? So, if may circular path, ibig sabihin, titignan mo yung formula ng velocity nung centripetal acceleration. Diba? So, meron tayo nun sa kinematics. So, dito mare-refresh. Kaya yun, no? Sinabi dito, that is the force is equal sa mass times the square of velocity divided by the radius. So, i-recall nyo yung centripetal acceleration. Doon na-derive yan. Yung force is equal sa mass times the square of velocity o velocity square divided by the r. And then, alam natin yung formula. So, since may given a charge, so, pwede natin gamitin yung force is equal sa QBB sine theta. Wala namang given na current dito, di ba? So, gagamitin natin yung may charge. And then, since yung dalawang formula na ito, yung MB square over R, tsaka yung QBB sine theta, is parehas equal to force, di i-equate mo yan sa isa't isa. Since that is the same force. And then, if you equate that two equation, makukuha natin yung value for the velocity. So, dito pinakita that QBB sine theta is equal sa MB square over R. So, makakancel yung isang V and then makukuha natin yung value ng V. So, ang V by rearranging the formula that is equal, so ang square of the velocity is equal sa QBB sine theta R divided by the mass. And then, makakancel yung isang velocity. So, velocity is simply equal to 105.4 meter per second. So, kitang-kita kung paano na-cancel out yung units. Wherein, dito yung column, ginawa mong ampere second. Tapos, since ang given is 3 Newton per ampere meter, so, ano na siya? So, tawag doon. So, that is 3 kilogram per second square over ampere. So, may kulang ako dito. Tama. Ampere lang siya. Then, sine 45 times 25 times 10. Or 2 times 10 raised to negative 10 meter. Then, divided by 9.11 times 10 raised to negative 31. So, makakancel yung mga units involved. So, ang may iwan is meter per second. Ito siya. Yung meter dito and then yung second sa tabi nung in newtons. Yung nakuha sa newtons. So, again, velocity is equal sa 105.4 meter per second. So, nakuha na natin yung velocity, masusolve natin yung force. Kasi yun na lang yung kulang natin yung velocity. Kasi meron tayong magnetic field, meron tayong sine theta. And then, nakuha na natin, meron namang given a charge. So, doing that, we can solve it using the formula QBB sine theta. And then, makukuha natin, so makikita rin yung unit cancellation dyan, which is 3.58 times 10 raised to negative 17 Newton. So, yan yung for the number 1. And then,